this is going to be Risk of Rain. I got this game yesterday. It's a lot of fun, and it's been almost all over the place right now. And I'm thinking of starting a series on it. If you guys want to see more, please leave a link, comment, subscribe if you want. Comment what other games you'd like to see. And anyways, let's get on with it. I've barely played this game. I've played for only about 40 minutes, but I'm going to be starting a new single player game. I know the very, very basics of the game, but it's nothing too crazy right now. I'm going to start playing on, I guess, medium mode or rainstorm mode and see how far I can get this video. I'm not too sure how long it will last. It depends on how long I get, how far I get in the game, I guess. So, let's get into the game. Alright. So, if anybody hasn't seen this game yet, which I'd be pretty surprised if you haven't, because it's, once again, it's been, I've seen this game all over the place. This game is pretty much a roguelike game, so, and it's a sequel of the original Risk of Rain. I've never played the original Risk of Rain, but this game came up on my Steam recommended, and it looked very interesting, and I've played a very small bit, like I said already, and it's a lot of fun. Anyways, so there's gonna be mobs that are gonna be spawning, and then you can get money, like this mob right here. You have it's gonna have multiple characters, and then every character will have different abilities. So, and every time you kill an enemy, it's gonna drop money, and then if you saw it, the chest over the while ago, there was a chest on the ground. That chest on the ground, it has like different items and stuff like that. Can give me items that can help me progress further on in the game. To get to the next floor, I guess you could call it, you have to beat the boss at the teleporter, and once you do that, you can go move down to the next floor. So this is one of the chests, and I just got Bustling Fungus, which heals me if I stand still for 2 seconds. I'm probably not going to do very well on this for the first couple of rounds, or the first couple of videos for that matter, but it is quite a lot of fun. Other roguelikes I really enjoyed playing is like Binding of Isaac, and I will be making some videos on Virtual Dungeon, the new update that's going to come on Friday for me. Also enjoy to see that. But anyways, in the bottom left corner, as you can see, there's my health and my level. I'm not too sure exactly what level does, but I'm guessing it just increases your damage and health and other stuff like that. From the small time I played, I'm pretty sure that's the conclusion I came to at least. So as you can see, I have M1, M2, Shift, and R abilities. So my M1 is just a basic shot, my M2 is like a more powerful shot that pierces, and then my shift is a roll type thing, which I can do with my ability, with my armor is like a rapid fire and stunned ability. This is shops, they're kind of all over the place, and you can buy one item from them, and most of the time you know what items that you're going to be getting, but sometimes you won't. I'm not too sure what any of these items do, but this one. Cancel, chance to move enemies on hit. Well, seems a little bit of damage behind us, always nice. So, monster. No idea what that is. If anybody does know what that is, please help me. Please tell me what that monster lock thing is. It's just like something I need to collect more. This is the teleporter, so there's gonna be one of these on each map. I'm not too sure if I want to do this yet because I'm still very, very weak. There's another shop. It's just one. I know what this one does. It's an extra speed boost, which is always very, very good in these games. Not too sure if it's amazing at this one, but. Yeah, yes, it does heal you. Okay, I gotta make sure that's just... Which, that would actually help me quite a lot. So after I kill some of these enemies, I'll try to... I'm gonna go do the boss. Or the teleporter for the next. And as the longer you go into the game, the more difficult it gets. see in the top right corner. Right now I'm still on easy, but it will be progressing. Try that one again. Still gonna go on the same difficulty at least, but I might try to get some more items before I end up fighting the boss. No idea what this is. It costs 25 and I currently only have 15. I'll make sure to come back to that. Sounds good. Probably shouldn't be doing that, especially with my current skill level in this game. This is one where you have to pay money to activate it. I got the same thing. I didn't get anything that time. Probably shouldn't be using that. Different rarities to the chests also. These weird circle ones just give you some money. There's the small and large chests, I'm pretty sure. And the large chests have a greater chance of giving you better items. I do have is if I get another gasoline, does it do more damage? Does it increase the effect? Stuff like that. person is a turret, so he will, he does only stand in one spot, but he will shoot a lot of things, but it's currently not that big of a, I don't really need him, so I would rather sit behind two spots. There are some, they're called element enemies, the like, shine, like the blue ones, the blue fire person that you just saw up there. They have some like extra shielding, so they're just harder to kill, but they also have special effects when they hit you, so I'm gonna make sure that you stay. Get rid of those guys as fast as you can so they don't end up killing you. I'm sure all of you guys are much better at this game than I am currently, but that's why all the tips are here. And if you get too close to the enemy, it's gonna hit you too much. Give it probably one or two more goes, depending on, once again, how far I can, how long I survive for. Hopefully with time I'll get much, much better. So on this, I'm on a different map this time, so more areas to learn and explore. Like I said, I'm going to be streaming and entering the content series as soon as the new update comes out. I hope all of you guys will enjoy that. So this chest over here is one of the bigger chests. It's not one of the bigger chests. I want to show you guys that is not for something. Just having some did before the thing did about 4 damage a second or something, but no, it's gonna be, it's probably does more. Okay, so these guys have to be delayed fire, that's why I keep on getting hit by them. Maybe it's just more like the chain that didn't happen. how I can improve about this game and tell me about some of the questions I have asked. But anyways, I'll see you in the next episode, and I will hopefully.